Hi, this is Larry Fish. Those of you that are watching, that are looking to learn about the spinal cord stimulator, I'm not going to say much about it other than 3 years later, to me, it was a bad decision and made my problem more complicated than it was, and has left me with just some new pain and new scar tissue. And the Boston Scientific rep, about $100,000 richer. Over the course of the last week, I have been recording myself wanting to share a story that has been chewing me up inside for many years. And it's about addiction. And it's about love. Unconditional agape love. The story's not about religion, not about church. This morning, I was laying on the couch and laying on the heating pad, just wanting to feel better, so I can get off my ass and come into the studio and try and get this done. And while I was laying there, I got a pop-up message that someone had watched a few of my earlier YouTube videos that I did on my spinal cord stimulator, and I get at least one or two a week. It's not a lot, but you know, at least one a week. Someone telling me these stories, how they're jacked up on opiates, in pain and just so desperate for relief, and like wanting me to write them back and please give them hope that a spinal cord stimulator is going to work. And there's a lot of people that are worse off than me. But I was, you know, when that popped up, and I, at that moment, my mind was just on the pain that I was in and wanting it to go away, so that I could reveal to the world what's been burning in my heart for the last 10 years. And it's turned into a wildfire the last 2 years since I've had quite a turnaround as far as the kind of health care that I've been getting and being off prescription opiates almost 2 years. Yes, I've been to the hospital. Yes, I've had shots. But it's almost 2 years without opiates. And my head's clear. And my heart's pounding. If you're here watching this wanting to know about a spinal cord stimulator, I say do the trial. Be honest with yourself. And there's some people it helps, some people it doesn't. And then there's some people eventually makes their problem worse. And I was the latter of the three. But I guess I'm kind of combining two things. This is like an introduction to a new series that I'm going to do. Over the last 2 years, we moved from Buffalo back to Nashville, and I ended up at an alternative medicine called the alternative medicine practice. It was a group of doctors, psychologists, acupuncture counselors, teachers, academics. I took classes, living well with chronic pain, meditation, yoga, massage, counseling, pain counseling. And really, really became educated in how to consciously look at your pain. And I, you know, has there been improvement? Tremendous. Last few months, I've been on a downswing. Scar tissue is hardening in the areas where the batteries were. They're surrounding the nerves and the muscle tissue, and it being hurts. And it interferes with your brain sometimes. But I invite you to follow me over the course of the next several months. And I am going to dig in to every alternative treatment that I can afford, and supplements, changing how I eat and what I put into my body. We're going to do that one step at a time, and I would love feedback and support from you all out there, because I got to tell the addiction story. Hey, I need support. I know there's people that believe in me. One of the main aspects of this story that I want to tell is about unconditional love. Let's start with my wife. Should have, could have left me many times, but did not. And what was she doing a week ago? Sitting at the hospital with me. Before I started with all this chronic back stuff, I was an addict. And guess what? It didn't start with marijuana. It started with alcohol. And then the next thing that I did was take my father's prescription painkillers. It wasn't until a year or two after, when I didn't have access to the pills anymore, I started going to a dealer. And that's where the real good stuff was introduced. My wife and I are currently reading a book by Dr. Osborne called No Grain, No Pain. And I love my cereal and I love my bread, but I hate the pain more. And I'm going for it. I would love the support from all of you. I think I'm gonna do these weekly, real simple, 10 minutes, how it's going, things I've done throughout the week, track my weight loss. I still need to lose about 40 pounds. When I moved to Tennessee in 2014, I was 275. I'm now 250. I can't lay on the couch anymore. And I know there's so many people out there that have real pain and have gotten to the point you can't stand to look at a pharmacy bottle, no matter what's in it. You just want to be pain free. Apologies for my me getting emotional, but this is It's like these things are intermingled. And I'm going to do another video that's dedicated to my story. My story is built around an album that is by Resurrection Band, written by Glenn Kaiser, called Lament. It's right behind me. It is a 13-song music video with only 5 words of dialogue that takes you on a journey from the beginnings of my addiction to the climax in 2006, where I robbed a convenience store, ran from the police, was beat up, televised arrest, to rehab, to being failed by the medical care, being failed by Western medicine, to really no happy, perfect ending. Other than that, I'm alive and my wife is still here. My family still loves me. And I'm not dead. So, we're going to do 2 series here. So, we're going to do a weekly video on my update and how I'm doing with the alternative treatments that I'm going to continue, the alternative treatment that I am choosing to do. I do have to have a myelogram, and it is going to be honestly evaluated by a couple of neurosurgeons, and whether or not structurally I need surgery to prevent me from becoming paralyzed, which is a possibility someday, but I'm hoping way down the road. But in the meantime, a new way to eat, a new way to look at food. Supplements, lose weight, positive feedback, and we'll see what happens. Please tune in to my next video. This one is specifically about my story and how this has evolved over the last decade. Thanks for watching. Peace.